And we're back. What's the answer, Michael?
Okay, so it depends.
What does it depend on? I've given you everything. This is straightforward.
Well, so, okay, I guess. Here's what I'm seeing. So what I'm seeing is that hypothesis one is the most likely hypothesis.
It's not just the most likely. It's the most a posteriori.
Well, that's what I mean by likely, right? It is the map hypothesis. It's the maximum a posteriori hypothesis. So if we say, what is the label according to the map hypothesis? Boom, it's plus.
Yes.
But if we're saying, what's the most likely label? So the most likely label is we have to actually look over all the hypotheses and, in a sense, let them vote. And so the probability that the label is minus is actually 0.6, which is greater than 0.4. So if I had to pick, I would go with minus.
And you would be correct. So I did a little tricky thing here for you, Michael. You've been complaining about my titles because everyone said Bayesian learning, and I changed the title here to Bayesian classification. Because, in fact, the problem here we've been talking about all along is, what's the best hypothesis? But here, I ask you, what's the best label?
Mm.
And exactly as you point out, finding the best hypothesis is a very simple algorithm. Here, I'll write it for you because we did it before. For every H in the hypothesis set, simply compute the probability that it is the best one, and then simply output max. That's how you find the best hypothesis, but that's not how you find the best label. The way you find the best label is you basically do a weighted vote for every single hypothesis in the hypothesis set according to the weight being the probability of that hypothesis given the data.
Okay.
So the best, if you can only output a hypothesis and use that hypothesis, in fact, you would say plus. But if you asked everyone to vote, just like we did with boosting, just like we did effectively with KNN and all these other kind of weighted regression techniques we've used before, you need to do the voting.
And I feel like I could probably derive that using rules of probability, right? Because really what we want is we're trying to maximize the probability of the label given the data. And I think that probability laws would tell us that that is equal to the sum of all hypotheses of the hypothesis and the label given the data, which is like the probability of the hypothesis given the data times the probability of the label given the hypothesis. And that's what we did. We summed up, you know, the probability of the label given the hypothesis is either 1 or 0. That's your left column. And then we're summing up the probabilities that correspond to the pluses, and we're summing up the probabilities corresponding to the minuses and choosing the largest one.
So this is what you just said written down as an equation. Basically, the most likely value is the one that maximizes this expression. And this follows directly from Bayes' rule, where now instead of trying to maximize a hypothesis given the data, you're trying to maximize a value given the data. And I think it's pretty straightforward to derive that, but I'd like to leave it up to the students to do it on their own. Okay, so Michael, in some sense, everything that I've told you before is a lie, and that I've led you down this path that somehow finding the best hypothesis is the right thing to do. But the truth is, finding the value is what we actually care about. Finding a hypothesis is just a means to an end. And if we have a way of actually computing the probabilities for all the hypotheses, then we should let them vote in order to find the best actual label or the best value for them.
Got it.
All right. Good.